Greetings for the Earthlings, welcome back to Delta Force 2. We are continuing with Operation Global Enforcement. In fact, this is the last mission from this campaign. The mission at hand is for Horsemen. Now this is a secret mission, and the way to unlock this mission is to, well, grab a laptop computer in Mission Broken Wing that you'll find in one of the, you know, bunker complexes. And yeah, that's how you unlock this mission. And it's actually a sidetrack. We are sort of getting sidetracked by doing this mission here. Like, if we were doing this during the main campaign, but which we are not. So right now, this is like, I'm placing this mission here as more of a fact of tying up loose ends, if you will. Anyhow, Russian General Mirkov has been abducted and is being held near your area of operation. Assist Spetznaz command in freeing the general. Let's listen to the mission briefing then.
We have a departure from your current mission profile. 12 hours ago, Russian General Anatoly Mirkov was abducted from his summer home and taken to a facility near your current location. A Russian Spetsnaz unit is mobilizing for a rescue mission, but due to helicopter malfunctions, their second squad is unable to engage the site in time. Because of Delta's proximity and alert status, we are lending a hand. Your insertion point will be 300 meters south of the objective. Once on the ground, you will be in direct contact with the Spetsnaz commander. Their forces will be approaching from the north. Proceed to the objective and locate the general. Once you are inside the perimeter, helicopters will land to secure the courtyard and provide extraction.
Okay, so right off the bat, as we can see on the map, it is inside of a valley. And given the fact that we cannot exactly use grenade launchers to clear out buildings in this particular mission, it seems sort of pointless to be carrying a grenade launcher with us. So what we'll do instead is we'll rely on a sniper instead to take out all the enemy combatants from the outside. And as far as the buildings themselves, I suppose we'll just have to rely on our trusty sidearm if nothing else works. Because there's like a lot of hills in the area. It's a pretty hilly region, and we'll have the high ground during the assault. Now, one of the things that I really like is the fact that there are multiple allies for us here. Like, we've got two of our own folks right here, and there's like, I think those are vehicles. I'm not sure whether they're vehicles or like groups of Spetsnaz operatives, to be honest. This seems like an exciting mission. Let's select a gear then. So instead of the shotgun, I would like to take the sniper rifle instead. And we have been given a law. I don't know why we are getting the law, but if the game typically gives you a law, you better take it because it's gonna be useful. Let's start the mission then.
Bravo King 6, we have confirmation that the general is still in the base. Move in and provide security for extraction.
Roger King 6.
This group leads to all groups. Spetsnaz 3 and 4 will land when the courtyard is clear. Spetsnaz 1 and 2 are in position. We will follow your lead, Bravo.
Shooters in the towers! Shooters in the towers!
Yes, I know, Alpha. I know there are supposed to be shooters in the towers. You guys need to be cautious though, you know? You guys aren't exactly running a charity game. I know you guys idealize giving your life for
Alpha 1 is down!
Nation.
Bravo, King 6, Alpha team is down!
Who the fuck are you shooting at? Look at that Terminator guy. Wannabe Terminator. I thought there was supposed to be somebody here. There's a guy here. I wonder if we can shoot him. Found one guy here. The Spetsnaz also die in this game, so we gotta be careful about that. The Spetsnaz dying. If the Spetsnaz die, then, well, it's sad. We lose even more of our comrades than we ever did. More of the we keep losing more comrades. It's not a good situation for the Spetsnaz to die. Albeit temporary, they are helping us through this mission. So I think it best to...
This is Charlie 1. The courtyard is secure.
Roger, Charlie. Bravo, move in and clear out the buildings.
Roger, King 6. Yeah, that guy got it. These enemies sometimes take their own sweet time in responding. Which sort of...
Spetznaz 2 is down.
Alright. The Spetznaz are dying. Time to move. Oh wait, the Spetznaz are actually mounting an offensive onto the damn place. Which is crazy. I mean, I didn't think they would be doing that, but here they are. Oh yeah, there are a few bad guys down there, aren't there?
Bravo, King 6.
Yeah, I was trying to shoot him before any of that happened, but I guess that's a no-go. Oh, look at that. I mean, this run-through seems to be going far better than my previous run-through. Because the previous time around, the helicopters never came and the Spetsnaz all died. I guess that's a Spets... Oh no. I failed. What the hell? No. You guys need to chill. Alright, you guys need to chill. Okay. Alright, you're good. No wonder that they were giving us the loss. Because my god. That would have gone bad in a hurry. Well, glad to see that he's just been hit and he's not actually dead. So I suppose that's a start. Although I just wonder who killed him. Who done him in. But there are folks in there that we need to be careful of. So, yeah, there are folks in there. In case you guys didn't know, there are plenty of folks in there. And it's best to advise, exercise as much caution as possible. That is clear, that building. No threats in that building over there. But there is one threat in that building, I do believe. I think all the Spetsnaz are dead at this point. Good thing is, the choppers are here. Which will enable us in... Oh, taking cover. Which will enable us to take cover. Because this is technically a bad guy in that impact grenade. I think this is good range. Voila. Oh. I think there was a bad guy there. Slow. Voila. Oh. Excuse me. So I wanna take my time going through this. There's already a bad guy in here. Just around this corner, and... There's one right there. Beyond those boxes there. First one to see him gets the kill. I do not think there are any more here, but... Just to be sure, we are going to do a complete sweep of the area. And this is where I died the last time to this guy sitting parked camped right here. Oh, somebody got him as well. I think it was me. Or maybe Alpha or Charlie or somebody else. I don't think anybody's up there, and I do not want to check a grenade there. To check because, well, the general's there. And of course, we'd not want to expose the general to any kind of danger. But these... Clearing these areas out is the most difficult. Primarily because of how enemies can be all over the place. Like, you're the most exposed whenever you're doing this. No enemies there. No enemies here either, up from the looks of it. That's good. I do not think I made a sound going up. Do not see any enemies to my left. Clear. That side is clear. Reloading. Now, I do not exactly want to rush this, because if I do, then the general might just get hurt, and that is the last thing that we want, for the general to get hurt. Now, here's the funny part. I thought the general was supposed to be here. What? Where's the general? Is that the general? Did we just kill the general? I should hope not. That's apparently where the general was supposed to be. What's going on? Did I... Oh wait, we're supposed to go up, are we? I do hope that that is not the general. I mean, this guy's just standing and chilling, so... I don't know whether he is. I hear some guys walking about. And I do hope that those are not our friends. I do hope that they are our friends. Do not see anybody up here. Like I said, I hope that they are friends and not our enemies. Oh wait, maybe that was just me. So the general's not here. Which is strange, because the last time I pointed my scope at this building, it said general. So I don't know what's going on at this point, to be honest. Where is the general? Okay. Secure the general objective vampire. The general reaches extraction point. Reach the extraction point or eliminate all hostiles. So I'm guessing we're gonna have to go to route 2 then. Sequentially scan all these buildings and eliminate everybody that could be here. See, I hear somebody. I hear somebody sneaking about. But I can't see where they are. And that's the real sad part. In my humble opinion. If I am to opine on something, I would opine on that. Excuse me, don't fall off, thank you. Wait, is the general there this time around? No, it says Spetsnaz this time. Checking for enemies, probably are enemies in there. I doubt that the general would be in one of these buildings, yeah? Too open. I feel like, hunting the general would probably be the best play. Okay, suffered some fall damage there, but can't see any enemies thus far, which I think is fair for now. It just says Spetsnaz. But here's the thing, previously I pointed up onto that side and it said general here. So I honestly don't know what's going on. The general was supposed to be in this corner right here, but he's not there. So we'll do both. We'll keep eliminating all hostiles, and at the same time, we'll keep looking for the general. The general is definitely not in these two rooms, like buildings. These buildings are just not general safe, you know? Probably in one of the bigger buildings then. That building is clear, that much we know. There might be an enemy in the building in front of us. Scratch might, there most definitely is an enemy in the building in front of us. So, gotcha. Really? Ah! You know, you could have saved us both so much trouble by just dying. The thing is, my aim isn't the best out there, so that's one of the reasons why I like to play things a little methodically. I know everybody wants to be a Shroud. Or essentially a pro, you know. Esports gamer, but not everybody can be one. Hence, I like to take things slow and methodically. Increase my chances of survival. I'm just going to go over onto this side first. And this side is clear. This room is also clear. Now to clear out this room. That was a set of stairs, and I did not expect that enemy. Good thing my aim did not fail me. Otherwise, we would have had to retry this section then. That is the side entrance. Now we have two choices. We can go up the same way with the enemy, or we can go up a different way. I elect we go up this way. The problem with this way is that there are two rooms, and I don't know who's in either of these rooms. The last thing I want to do is get caught up in the middle of two guys who are trying to kill me. Nobody there. I'll get there later though. First, let me clear out this room.
King 6, escort the general to the transports.
Alright, General, calm down. Slow down there. Slow down, General. Slow down. Look at you! I mean, you even picked up a weapon. I mean, then again, it's a Kalashnikov, right? So, I suppose that's, that comes pretty natural to you. I don't know who's shooting, but somebody's shooting. And we're out of here. Now that the general is gone. We're gonna climb back onto this hill and circle this entire place and reach extraction. Now if we wanted like a greater challenge, we could have stayed back here and eliminated everybody from the base, but that is not what we're here for. So eyes on the mission and we extract while we still can. Just hoping that we don't get sniped by some random dude who dreams of being the next Vasily. Is that the guy that was trying to kill us? Well, one of the helicopters actually flew off. I don't know what happened to the other one though. Excuse me. I'm just scanning out for any opportunity targets at this point, and that's it. So yeah, we have rejoined with our waypoint marker, and we will attempt to now exfiltrate from the outskirts of this valley to a more suitable position. Yeah, I'm gonna go prone here because this seems pretty steep and I do not want to risk taking fall damage. This also gives me like a lot of cover to work with, which I can always appreciate. Alright, I think we should be far away enough from the camp to where none of the enemies would be able to probably shoot us. Sayonara, suckers! As far as the Spetsnaz is concerned, I was hoping you guys could make it, but it is sad that you guys cannot. And I will leave it at that. Wait, I'm actually going towards the insertion there. Oh no, I was supposed to head the other way. Oh well, fine. We'll circle the camp. I'm not going through it. No, I'm not going through it. See, that's the thing about this game. Unless and until you are explicitly following the waypoint markers, you might just get lost, like I did. We have to go all the way over there. Let's hope this is a negotiable face of the mountain. I don't want to die to fall damage and have to do all that all over again. Even though this is not a particularly difficult mission, is what I would say. Pretty easy mission, if you ask me. Does not mean that we get to jinx it, though. So yeah. Up the other side we go. Is that an enemy there? No, just the glass. Alright, up that mountain. Up that mountain it is. I know that there's somebody over there who would like a piece of us. I know that. Here's to hoping that they don't actually get a piece of us. And we can get on our way unmolested. I think that's where we were being shot from. Unless of course I could be wrong there though. I think this guy right there. But he seems dead. So. I don't know why, but the Spetsnaz just seem far more proficient at action than the Delta Force, based on whatever I've seen thus far. It's like the Delta Force guys, they go into an area just to die, and meanwhile the Spetsnaz, they're like, they actually killed quite a few folk there. There they are. Some of our Russian comrades. Let me just confirm. Yes, that is Objective Vampire. We go from there to Checkpoint Charlie. If Checkpoint Charlie was our extraction, then it would have been amazing, to be honest. But it is not. Now, the reason I went prone here is because if I'm moving slow, then I won't suffer fall damage when I fall. Look at that. Smooth. And since I already took fall damage once in this game, the chances of well, dying to fall damage are pretty high right now. So Delta Force is essentially one of those games which gets significantly more difficult as you keep, you know, going away from the waypoint markers. And it's like the complete opposite of Delta Force 1. In Delta Force 1, if you stuck to the waypoint markers, you were the most likely to die. In Delta Force 2, the waypoint markers are essentially the way you are supposed to play the mission. That's like the easiest route through it. If you deviate from the waypoint markers, the chances of your survival go extremely low. The general has been extracted. I just hope there are no more enemies up ahead. None are showing up on the map. Now, I was sort of, you know, I was sort of curious about taking the Spetsnaz helicopter back there, but unfortunately,
all King Elements, good job. Black Widow is inbound for pickup.
That's not a Delta Force helicopter, and apparently neither is this. So apparently, looks like we're essentially going on a Spetsnaz helicopter then. Huh. King 6, this is Bravo 1. I'm booting the Spetsnaz helicopter. Bravo 1 is RTB. Alpha and Charlie fire teams, as well as a bunch of the Spetsnaz operatives, have been our KIA. Over and out. No, I'm just waiting to get to the helicopter at this point. I mean, I know the mission's already over, I can just hit enter and end the mission, but Yeah, I just want to seal the deal, if you get what I mean. I can hear another helo, which is sort of strange. I was not expecting to hear another helo. I just hope that is not a double cross. Where do I get in? Open the door, helicopter. Open the door. Oh, here it is. Alright, let's go then. What the fuck are you two guys doing here? Aren't you gonna come help? Anyhow. And that was that. I mean, it was surprisingly easy for a, you know, secret or hidden secret mission rather. This is not a hidden mission. Operation Common Resolve is the one that has a hidden mission. So yeah, this was actually surprisingly simple for a hidden mission, to be honest. A secret mission. And yeah, I actually enjoyed it. I actually enjoyed it. Just the same way that I enjoyed what was that? Bounty Hunter. The secret mission of Operation Common Resolve. The title was right in front of me, but I forgot how to read. Anyhow, this is pretty much it for this video, as well as for Operation Global Enforcement. Now, by the time you guys watch this, I will have already completed a 14th mission here, which is actually a hidden mission called Hound Dog for Operation Common Resolve. It was probably planned to be in the game, but then cut later, or maybe some bug or something occurred and they did not really patch it out. So this, for to unlock this mission, it's there in the game, but to unlock this mission you need to use like a registry editor or like a hex editor. I don't exactly know what to call it. So there's like this sub program that you use to, you know, change bits and stuff on your save file to unlock the mission. And that's pretty much how you unlock this mission. So yeah, I will have completed that mission. But as far as Operation Global Enforcement is concerned, we are finished with it. So the next time we come back for you guys, it will be, we'll be continuing Delta Force 2 with the this collection of 20 amazing quick missions. These are essentially independent scenarios, independent of both the campaigns and independent of each other. So yeah, pretty much, this is pretty much what we are going to do. 6 of 1, starting with 6 of 1, of course. And yeah, I have a feeling these are going to be hard. Anyhow, until then, thank you so much for tuning in, thank you so much for watching, and thank you so much for sticking around until the end. See you later. Take care. Fare thee well, fellow workings.